President and Chief Executive, Srimati S.R.D. Vice President, Deputy Chief Executive and Correspondent, Dr. Silesh Sampathi. Associate Vice President and Principal, Srimati Deepika Sampathi. Esteemed guests, grandparents, parents, colleagues, and my little loving students, a very good morning. As the headmistress of this school, I am humbled. At the same time, I also feel proud and privileged to work under a great leader, our President Arti Ma'am, who is one of the 100 successful women entrepreneurs in Telangana state, chosen by the Confederation of Women Entrepreneurs. Congratulations, ma'am, on receiving this prestigious award. One round of applause to ma'am, please. You are all aware about our Diamond Jubilee celebrations, which have been planned well in advance. As a part of this plan, we have already started with a band training to our high school students. Training is provided by the professional trainer who is retired from police services. The instruments are made available for the practice under the supervision of band master. In this regard, we propose to invite our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi as chief guest to Hyderabad. In case if his schedule will not permit him to travel to Hyderabad, we propose to lead our delegation to New Delhi. So we thank our parents for their quick response to this invitation proposal, and I am sure with your support, we will definitely make this celebrations once in a lifetime event. And this invitation proposal is first of its kind, proposed by our correspondent Dr. Silesh Sampathi, who is an embodiment of values, standing tall in spite of odd difficulties. We believe in excellence. We believe in organizing things that would reflect on what our value system stands for, thereby setting a new benchmark. It is easy to teach and go, but it is difficult to inspire, give live opportunities and hands-on activities to our children. We dare to do it, and we definitely will do it well. We strongly believe that what we are today, it is because of our past, and we will be the custodians of the value system which has not been transformed. I meet lot of young parents coming to me, ma'am, it is becoming difficult to control our children. They are not listening to us. Please advise us what we should do. I think it is our eroding value system that is making your child, your parent, and you the one who is following the instructions from your child. So as parents, remember that what your parents taught you, the values they taught you, the way they got you understand, this is exactly what we have to do with our young children. And in Indian culture, we consider the teacher as guru. Understand the fact and respect the teacher, so that we get better output from them, thereby your children getting benefited. The moment you are going to speak against teachers, against school, it is your child who is going to suffer, nobody else. The school will go on and it will carry forward what it has to carry forward. You are taking care of one or two kids at home, but our teachers take care of 30 kids whole day in the class. So look at the service what the school is providing you, rather than finding fault with one small thing probably being interpreted wrong by you or by your kid or by the teacher. Here we are handling different age groups, right from tender nursery group to sensitive teens or adolescents. It's not an easy task. Kindly, we expect parents to understand the work strain of our teachers. Recently, we had a small assembly performance in primary section at C block on a plastic-free world. So in this context, I just briefed them about the harmful effects of the plastic to environment and suggested both teachers and children to replace the plastic containers. And there was a drastic change on the immediate next day. Especially kids from first class were eagerly waiting for me with excitement to show their steel water bottles and steel lunch boxes. And to my surprise, one student came forward with a diary note by the parent, "Ma'am, give us one more day time to replace the plastic containers." So such small acts can bring about big changes or big differences, which gives us really utmost satisfaction. We as teachers swell with pride when we see our children coming back to us, doing well in life, in various fields, contributing globally. So we expect parents to understand this. So we are next to parents taking care of them. And keeping in mind the changing the scenario and the kind of news we hear every day, be it Nirbhaya or Disha, we teachers have realized that our role has become extensive in parenting the child, inculcating the values rather than teaching the child alone. Remember that present contains past. We could do nothing without the past, and future depends on the present. So my appeal to all parents here, we teachers and you parents must put our hands together to restore and reform the eroding value system so that we have better future. So it's time for the show. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the budding talents of our budding blossoms. Thank you.